Well, folks, here we are out in the desert in California, and I must say, it's a beautiful place to be. However, everywhere we go, we have animosity with the folks that find out we're hunting. But I guess that's just how part of being a hunter here in California. But I will say we've had some good news today and some bad news. First off, the good news is we found some fresh coyote scat here in the desert. And so this is a good place that we're going to go up this valley and set up the call and see if we can call something in. But the bad news is, as we take a look down here, whoever you are out there in California, if you're missing Oliver, this is where we assume he must rest.
You may not want to know me, but you probably already do. I'm the guy they say is crazy, and for the most part, I guess it's true. If you've never been scared, you never hunted with me. And when it's time to feed, they better hope I'm not the guy in the tree. My friends, well, they're crazy too. They like to hunt things that want to kill them. And like me, killing's what they do. It's not easy to like me, and I understand why. For the creatures that I meet have a tendency to die. If they took my gun, I'd still be dangerous. And if you're the guy who comes to get it, remember, dying's no way of living. So don't get in a rush. So when they ask me if I'm a killer, he who hunts both sea and land, I'll just smile and give the answer. Yes. Why, yes I am. I have hunted God's creatures on every corner of the world. I have witnessed things that most men will never see. But when you think you've seen it all, you soon realize that you haven't. I've traveled to the outskirts of LA, California, and it's here that Bruce Oldenkamp called jackrabbits to within bow range. It was a first for me. Now, some jackrabbits would run in close, but most would hang up just on the edge of bow range. Coming to the call, they seemed to know we were there, and when they'd stop, they were poised to run at the shot.
Everywhere you go out here in the desert, there's all different sizes, medium, large, and small. Just like humans, at every stage of life, and the ground is just saturated with it. I mean, everywhere you go, there's rabbit poop. So there's been generation after generation of jacks and cottontails out here, and there's plenty of them, but they're not easy to kill. You do call them in, but every once in a while, you'll get one to come right up to you, but usually they stay back and look. And I'm not sure what they're coming for. You got any idea, Bruce? Are they coming for Magombo, or are they coming because they're just curious?
Maybe curiosity.
Maybe so. Maybe a little bit of both. But whatever it is, keep doing what you're doing, buddy. Keep doing it. One of these days, I'm going to hit one.
We're going to get lucky and score.
I'm ready.
There's millions of jacks throughout the western deserts. I'm hoping to kill one.
Yeah.
my arrow has passed through a big jackrabbit. A trail of blood stains his track.
First jackrabbit I've ever killed by calling them in and killing them. Wow, big old male too. Here we are right in the middle of California, real close to LA, and I got 18 wheelers going by on this side, houses up on this side, you know, mountain bike riders all around me. It's crazy here, but there's animals that live right here in the city, and it hasn't been easy, let me tell you. We've called a lot in and a lot of them got away, but we've managed to kill a few. And that last one was a prime example of calling in jackrabbits. And I want to thank Bruce. Way to go, buddy. Way to call
good
him
job.
In here. He called me and said, hey, man, I can call jackrabbits as good as I can coyotes. Well, I must say, he wasn't lying. That was awesome.
From the very beginning, man has followed the spoor of his slain quarry. I am living out my God-given right.
Archery. Woo! Score! Let's go see if we can find that rabbit. Come on.
Joining me on this hunt is my agent and good buddy, Eric Welch. Like me, Eric loves to bow hunt. And his job is to try and keep me out of trouble. Now, the pay's not too good, but I try and remind him that it's very rewarding.
Nice. Nice. What do you think, buddy?
Nice hard shot.
Ten ringed him.
I knew if I went, he would have stopped, yeah. So I just let him go.
So glad you didn't get the shot.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
So this is what they look like here in California. And the jackrabbit's got super thin ears. You can see that. You got the veins in there, and when it gets up to 100 degrees here in the summer, keeps them nice and cool. And a lot of meat on these legs too. They got a long strip along both sides where their back straps, real thick section of meat. It's good to eat. And I know he's bloody, but I'll show it to you. That's the 10 ring on a jackrabbit. Yeah! Woo! It's been good today. Good in California. For all you people up there on the interstate cruising by, I hope some of you are tree huggers that hate us hunters here in California, because I just scored. Well, Bruce and I have been calling coyotes and crows all morning long, and I'm building up an appetite, so there's a really nice restaurant right ahead of us. We're gonna have some tamales. What do you say, Bruce?
Sounds excellent.
Let's
much needed nutrition.
Let's do this.
Hope they're having a sale.
They got hot waitresses there.
A one-stop shop, folks.
Oh, this is getting better. This is getting better.
$375.
Here you go, sweetheart. Keep the change.
Thank you, sir.
What's this guy got now?
This is
out here in the middle of the desert hunting coyotes. It's awesome. Food's showing up.
We just stop and they come.
My cameraman's getting fat. Let's go. Come on. Fresh made. It's hot. Wrapped in a corn stalk or something. Okay.
Some jacks would run right in, others were leery. They'd sneak in. It was fun. It reminded me a lot of predator hunting. And it was very easy to be distracted, for you'd watch rabbits from a distance. Meanwhile, another may sneak in through the back door. It's a game of patience and luck. For if you're patient, sometimes you get lucky.
Eric has scored. I was guarding the back door. I seen something coming through the brush. It vanished for a little bit. Next thing I know, slock! Dig it out, Eric. Show your arrow. Holy crap. What a great shot. Yeah. Oh, yeah. And look, right over here. That's a beauty. Look at the size of that rabbit. Nice. That's bigger than the one I shot.
Look at all the ticks on him.
Oh my gosh, he's covered with ticks. Look at his ears, you guys. Look at this. Ticks, all ticks on his ears. Nasty. Wow. Whew. Well, little wabbit, Eric put you out of all your tick misery. Way to go, buddy.
Dude, I'm telling you, something about calling him in.
Oh, you know what? Calling animals is just so awesome. Calling the crows this week has been so much fun. But our luck on the coyote hasn't been too good. But,
no.
You know, I think they've been called to death around here.
I think so.
Yeah. But nice shot, buddy.
Thank you.
Good job, man. We're doing good.
That was awesome.
We're doing good. What is that, four rabbits now?
That's four.
And I'll tell you what, nobody can call him like this guy right here. I'll tell you what, I'll take the camera from him. What is your secret, Bruce? What is your secret, buddy?
I don't have one.
You are a rabbit calling fool, man.
I guess that's all we can call this week.
This guy here is a killer, man. He's known for his stellar mule deer killing out in the flats, but you do a darn good job on the jackrabbits too, Bruce.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
I appreciate it.
And I love that little boy of yours, man.
Thank you.
He's a good looking kid.
Thank you.
All right.
Put Eric behind the camera.
Yeah, he deserves that. Yeah,
I'm ready.
Jacks use cover as they approach. They dart from shadow to shadow, trying to stay out of sight. A second rabbit has appeared. But he's fast. And he's gone before the arrow arrives.
Two misses.
I'm on him.
Did you get that chew out of your mouth?
I'm good.
I don't want my kids.
I'm chew free.
Okay. Well, folks, here we are in the desert here in California.
We've had a rough time of it so far, but finally our luck has changed. We've had some good luck and some bad luck, and now we just got some good news and some bad news. But the good news is we found fresh coyote scat right here in the middle of the desert, and we're thinking if we go up this valley at any moment, we could call in a coyote, you know, who knows?
Big mature coyote.
Yeah. But the bad news is that as we look at the scat of the coyote, I notice there's something here, and it appears to be some sort of collar. And so wherever you are out there, and because you're in California, there's a good chance you may be a tree hugger. If you're missing Oliver and you voted for us not to hunt here in California, or maybe you had something to do with getting rid of the lion hunting here in California, well, if you're missing your cat or possibly your little dog Oliver, we have an idea where he is. And here he is.
It wasn't long after that we spotted the prime suspect who had eaten Oliver. Cooling off from the midday heat, he stands in the shade, looking on as we call. I needed my signature 22 Magnum from XL Arms, but today I only had my bow. He's quite a bit out of range. If we could only call him closer, I'd kill him, then check his butt to see if the collar fits. When suddenly, Eric spots a jack just off to the side. Lucky for the coyote, but not so lucky for Bugsy. Soon after, another jack came to the call. We had to give him a double whammy, but we got him.
Eric the rabbit killer has slocked another one, Bruce. What do you think?
Another one down. Another one bites the dust.
I was kind of hoping that we wouldn't find that one, because if we didn't find another one for nightfall, we were going to have steaks tonight. But
right?
Now we're eating jackrabbit.
That was awesome. I didn't think we could even call rabbits in. They're coming in like elk. This is too much fun. Let's go kill another one.
Good shot, buddy.
Let's go.
Good
shot.
You're watching Relentless Pursuit, and we practice with the Glendale target. And my team used the IQ bow sight for perfect alignment every time.
Can you pan up to us now?
It's okay, buddy.
It's okay, buddy. It's okay.
Everything will be okay.
Stop smiling. Skittle. Stop smiling. Skittle.
Man. One more time. Take three.
A piece of flint was made to fly. Meat was brought home and no one asked him why.